After studying this module, you shall be able to know about general equilibrium of exchange. Learn the equilibrium conditions of general equilibrium. Understand general equilibrium under perfect competition in both exchange and production.
Since Ricardo, several theoretical models were developed to solve this principal problem and solve this principal problem of income distribution. In this model, we are going to focus on the marginal productivity of labor, that is produce minus rent is the sum of both wage and profit rather than simply equal to wages. The wage rate in Ricardian model is determined by the constant supply price in terms of corn and is independent of marginal productivity of labor. According to modern economic theory, the Ricardian hypothesis implies that at a given wage OW, there is infinite supply of labor. Similarly, the general equilibrium of production together with the general equilibrium of exchange requires that the marginal rate of transmission not only be equal to marginal rate of substitution of the consumers, but also marginal rate of substitution of X for Y of the two consumers be equal to each other. It is worth mentioning that point of general equilibrium is not unique, since it may occur at any point on the contract curve depending on a starting point, that is initial endowment point. However, with perfect competition in the product and the factor markets, only one such equilibrium case can be realized. That is, the general equilibrium can be unique. Of course, it depends upon the initial endowment point. Let us discuss how it works in each case. We will first talk about perfect competition and general equilibrium of exchange.
We first understand that the general equilibrium of exchange occurs at a point on the contract curve where the marginal rate of substitution between two commodities MRSXY of the two individuals is the same. Likewise, the general equilibrium of production occurs at a point on the production contract curve where marginal rate of technical substitution between two factors in the production of two commodities by the two firms is the same. Similarly, the general equilibrium of production together with the general equilibrium of exchange requires that the marginal rate of transformation MRTXY not only be equal to marginal rate of substitution MRSXY of the consumers but also MRSXY of the two consumers be equal to each other. Next, it is important to state that point of general equilibrium is not distinct since it may be we fall at any point on the contract curves depending on a starting point, that is initial endowment point. However, with perfect competition in the product and factor markets, only one such equilibrium case can be realized, that is the general equilibrium can be unique. Of course, it depends upon the initial endowment point.
Let us first explain general equilibrium of exchange under competitive conditions. Under perfect competition, the number of sellers is assumed to be so large that the share of each seller in the total supply of product is very small. Therefore, no single seller can influence the market price by changing its supply. Similarly, the number of buyers is so large that the share of each buyer in the total demand is very small and that no single buyer can influence the market price by its decisions. He takes the price of goods X and Y as given. Consumer A maximizes satisfaction by equating his marginal rate of substitution with the given price ratio, that is marginal rate of substitution of A for consumer A, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for consumer A is equal to price of X upon price of Y. Similarly, for individual B, the marginal rate of substitution of X for Y is equal to the price of X upon price of Y. Since under the assumption of perfect competition, both the individuals A and B will be facing same price, it follows that marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for consumer A is equal to marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for consumer B, which is equal to the price of X upon price of Y.
Let us discuss how it works in case of perfect competition. Under perfect competition, the number of sellers is assumed to be so huge that the share of each seller in the total supply of a product is very small. Therefore, no single seller can affect the market price by altering his supply. Similarly, the number of buyers is so large that the share of each buyer in the total demand is very small, and that no single buyer can influence the market price. He takes the prices of goods X and Y as given. Consumer A maximizes his satisfaction by equating his marginal rate of substitution MRS XY with the given price ratio. Similarly, the individual B would be maximizing his satisfaction when marginal rate of substitution is equal to the price ratio of commodity X and Y. Since under the assumption of perfect competition, both the individuals A and B will be facing same prices, it follows that marginal rate of substitution for both consumers A and B will be equal to the price ratio of commodity X and Y is the required condition for unique general equilibrium of exchange under the conditions of perfect competition. Now consider from the figure an economy containing two individuals A and B who consume two commodities X and Y. Suppose the initial endowments of individuals A and B is given by point R. P dash is the price line with the price ratio PX by PY, which is drawn through the initial endowment point R. It is this line which becomes the budget line for the two consumers. This PP dash budget line also passes through two tangent indifferences curves at point E in figure. With initial endowment point R as the starting point and point E where they reach the equilibrium position, individual A has sold commodity AX and bought commodity Y, whereas individual B has purchased X and sold commodity Y. Given the price ratio PX by PY of two commodities by the slope of the budget line PP1 dash, the two individuals reach equilibrium at point E, where the quantity of commodity X is demanded by B equals the quantity of commodity X supplied by A, and similarly, quantity demanded of commodity Y equals the quantity supplied of commodity Y. Thus, point E is a location of competitive equilibrium, and therefore general equilibrium of exchange exists.
General equilibrium is a set of prices at which quantity demanded equals the quantity supplied in each and every market. Market clearing equilibrium determines not only the final allocation of commodities between the two consumers, but also unique price ratio equal to the each consumer's marginal rate of substitution between two commodities X and Y at the equilibrium point. It may be noted that not all prices are consistent with general equilibrium under perfect competition. For instance, price ratio of the two commodities shown by the price line SS prime, which also passes through the initial endowment point R.
We know that general equilibrium is a set of prices at which quantity demanded equals the quantity supplied in each and every market. Market clearing equilibrium determines not only the final allocation of commodities between two consumers, but also unique price ratio equal to each consumer's MRS between two commodities X and Y at the equilibrium point. It may be distinguished that not all prices are in accordance with general equilibrium under perfect competition. For illustration, price ratio of two commodities shown by the price line SS dash, which also passes through the initial endowment point R. Given the new price line SS dash, individual A is in equilibrium at Z and individual B is in equilibrium at K. That is, markets of two commodities X and Y are not in equilibrium because the marginal rate of substitution between X and Y of the two individuals are not equal to price ratio PX by PY at the same point. Hence, there is excess demand in one market of excess supply in other market. Thus, with the new price ratio line SS dash, the markets of two commodities are not in equilibrium.
Now we will talk about the perfect competition and general equilibrium of production. General equilibrium of production occurs on the production contract curve, where the marginal rate of technical substitution between any two inputs in any two firms is the same. The marginal rate of technical substitution is the amount that one input can be reduced if another input is increased by one unit, while total output remains constant. In other words, when the marginal rate of technical substitution of labor for capital in the production of commodity X equals the marginal rate of technical substitution of labor for capital in the production of commodity Y along the production contract curve, the general equilibrium of production is said to occur. In other words, when the marginal rate of technical substitution of labor for capital in the production of commodity X equals the marginal rate of technical substitution of labor for capital in the production of commodity Y along the production contract curve.
Next, we discuss perfect competition and general equilibrium of production. General equilibrium of production occurs on the production contract curve, where the marginal rate of technical substitution between any two inputs in any two firms is similar. The marginal rate of technical substitution, MRTS, is the amount that one input can be reduced if another input is increased by one unit, while total output remains constant. It can be said that when the MRTS LK in the production of commodity X equals the MRTS LK in the production of commodity Y along the production contract curve, the general equilibrium of production is said to occur. Profit maximizing firms under a competitive economy choose a mix of inputs such that the MRTS of different inputs is equal to the relative prices of those inputs. In case of two commodities X and Y, two factor inputs, labor L and capital K, remuneration of labor is W and that of capital is R. Thus, the profit maximizing condition is when the marginal rate of technical substitution between two inputs L and K of both commodity X and Y is equal to the factor price ratio, that is W by R. Now, under the assumption of perfect competition, all the firms face same factor price ratio W by R. Thus, we get that MRTS of commodity X and Y is equal to factor price ratio, that is W by R. Further, if all firms face the same relative prices of inputs, their MRTS will all be the same and general equilibrium of production will result. Thus, the general equilibrium of production, which means that the economy is on its production possibility curve, requires that the MRS between any two points be similar in all uses. Understanding this with the help of figure, we can see that A is the initial endowment point and relative factor input price ratio W by R line MM dash passes through this point and is tangent to X dash Y dash. Isoquants of X and Y commodities at point R of the production contract curve. The production equilibrium is not unique. The where and at what point on the contract curve depend on consumers' demand for X and Y. We know under the perfect competition and general equilibrium of production and exchange with help of two factors, labor and capital, two commodities X and Y and two consumers A and B economy, the general equilibrium of production and exchange occurs at a point where the marginal rate of transformation is equal to the marginal rate of substitution of both consumer A and B between commodities X and Y.
Now we'll talk about the general equilibrium in production and exchange simultaneously. General equilibrium of production and exchange requires that consumers' marginal rate of substitution equal the marginal rate of transformation. In the two factor labor and capital, two commodities X and Y and two consumers A and B economy, the general equilibrium of production and exchange occurs at a point where the marginal rate of substitution of both the households A and B for the two commodities, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household A is equal to marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household B, which has to be equal to the marginal rate of transmission of labor for capital for both the commodities, and this has to be equal to the price ratio or W by R. Perfectly competitive market results in an efficient distribution of goods among consumers. Each consumer maximizes his utility by equating marginal rate of substitution to the ratio of commodities prices. Perfectly competitive market results in an efficient allocation of inputs. Each firm produces at least cost by equating marginal rate of technical substitution between the factor inputs to the factor input price ratio. Since under perfect competitive market, factor input prices are same for all the firms, we have a situation where the as explained, marginal rate of technical substitution of labor for capital is the same for both, which is equal to W by R. Thus, the basic condition of general equilibrium, that the marginal rate of substitution must equal the marginal rate of transmission, will be satisfied in a competitive economy, because firms set the marginal rate of transmission equal to relative prices and consumers set the marginal rate of substitution equal to relative prices.
Now, perfectly competitive markets results in an efficient distribution of goods among consumers. Each consumer maximizes his utility by equating MRS to the ratio of commodity prices. For consumer A, marginal rate of substitution is equal to the price ratio PX by PY. Similarly, for consumers B, marginal rate of substitution is equal to the price ratio PX by PY. Since Competitive markets establish a uniform price for each commodity. The ratio Px by Py will be same for all consumers. Thus, marginal rate of substitution between commodity X and Y is equal for both A and B. Perfectly competitive markets results in an efficient allocation of inputs. Each firm produces at least cost by equating MRTS between the factor inputs to the factor input price ratio. For commodity X and Y, MRTS is equal to W by R. Since in perfect competitive market, factor input prices are same for all firms, we have MRTS for both X and Y equal to W by R. Also, the marginal rate of transformation between two commodities MRT XY is equal to the ratio of marginal cost of production of two commodities. Also, perfect competitive economy results in an efficient output mix. Each profit maximizing firm would equate the price of a commodity with its marginal cost of production, that is MCX is equal to PX and MCY is equal to PY. Now we know the slope of the production possibility curve, transformation curve is also equal to the ratio of the marginal cost of production. Thus, at equilibrium, in perfect competition, we have MRT XY equals to MCX by MCY equals to PX by PY. Since the consumers and firms face the same price ratio of the two commodities, we have MRT XY equals to MRS XYA equals to MRS XYB equals to PX by PY. Thus, the basic condition of general equilibrium states that the MRS must equals to the MRT will be satisfied in a competitive economy because firms set the MRT equals to relative prices and consumers set their MRS equal to relative prices. Now we understand this with the help of a figure where the x-axis represents the number of units of x and y-axis represents the number of units of y. Tx, Ty is the production possibility curve. Here the figure shows the equality between MRS XY and MRT XY and the slope of PP dash is equal to slope of TT dash. Also, MRT XY equals to MRS XYA is equal to MRS XYB equals to PX by PY. Thus, in this module, you have learned that in a perfectly competitive system, the factors and commodities markets will achieve an economically efficient outcome. A. Efficiently in exchange. In perfect competition, all consumers face the same prices. As a result of consumers in equilibrium, equate their MRS XY to product price ratio. B. Efficiency in production. It requires that MRTS between any two factors be the same for all commodities. With reference to two products X and Y and two factors L and K in our model, this condition may be expressed as MRTS LK X equals to MRTS LK Y equals to W by R. C. efficiency in production and exchange. We require that MRS XY A is equal to MRS XY B is equal to MRT XY equals to PX by PY.
We'll summarize the discussion. Essentially, what we have tried to study in this module is that in a perfectly competitive system, factor and commodity market will achieve an economically efficient outcome both in exchange as well as in production. In exchange, efficiency in exchange would be indicated at the point where the marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household A is equal to marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household B, and that is equal to the price of X upon price of Y. Likewise, the efficiency in production will be achieved at the point where the marginal rate of substitution of labor for capital is the same for both the commodities, and this has to be equated with the W by R. Under perfect competition, a profit maximizing firm sets its optimum combination of output where MRTS of X for Y is equal to change in Y upon change in X, which is equal to marginal cost of X upon marginal cost of Y. We also know that in a perfectly competitive market, MCX is equal to price of X and MCY is equal to price of Y. Therefore, marginal rate of technical substitution of X for Y is equal to MC of X upon MC of Y is equal to price of X upon price of Y. Since marginal rate of substitution of X for Y is equal to price of X upon price of Y, therefore, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household A is equal to marginal rate of substitution of X for Y for household B, which is equal to the marginal rate of transmission of labor for capital for the two commodities, and that is equal to the price of X upon price of Y. What follows from the above discussion is that all the marginal conditions of efficiency are met under the perfectly competitive framework.